G'day. I recently discovered the Bee Gees Night Fever multi-tracks were available online, and I was curious to have a look. So this is a bit of a walkthrough of what those files are and my mix of those files. So hang around. Night Fever was recorded in 1977, I think, as part of Saturday Night Fever, and not really my chosen genre, but it was a worldwide hit, and I was curious to see how the recordings stood up. There's 20 files. Some of them are stereo files. There's drums and percussion and bass and a couple of guitar tracks, a couple of keys tracks, and four vocal tracks, two of which are stereo. The band is pretty simple. One keyboard player, guitar, Barry, and they had a guitar player whose name escapes me. Alan Kendall, who played on several of their things. They had a keyboard player, and I think Morris Gibb played bass on this. It's a small tight band doing their thing with those vocals. Let's have a look through. The first thing to look at is the drums. I'll just take my processing off so you can hear the before and after. It's just two mono files, stereo, left and right. So I've just fully panned those. You can hear a bit of keyboard bleed in that one. There's bleed in a lot of these files, so that's something you can manage it, otherwise you just got to live with it. The way I've treated those, I mean, you can hear that's a pretty solid drum sound, but I've taken a fair bit of the mids out, 380-ish, and making room for the bass by taking some of the 100 out. I boosted at 50 and at 5k to help bring the snare out a bit more, and then done a bit of compression to help bring the transient out. I do some parallel compression as well, like using the same EQ settings but then running into the Kush UBK1 and giving that a bit of a hit. I take everything below about 200 out, so it's not responding to the low lows, but the general kit, and then I blend that in, and it smooths the cymbals out a little bit with the saturation, but also brings the transients out a bit more as well. So that's the drums. There's two percussion tracks. There's some triangle, I have that fairly back in the mix. I just take that bottom end out of that and don't do any other processing on it. And then we've got some shaker and do similar processing on that. You can even hear a little bit of the bleed in that. Then we've got the bass. Now the bass, I've duplicated the track that came with the set, so I'll take that out for the moment. Curiously, it was a stereo file. I don't know if there's any significance to that or not, but it was a stereo file in the 20 multitracks. I think that's an amp and a pick. And the way I treat baits is I take all the tops off one and all the bottoms off the other. So it's about 200 is the divider. So this is the sub 200 track. And then I'm compressing that pretty heavily to level out the bottom end. Then the top end is above 200. So I take all of the, I shelve all of the bottom end out, and then I use some decapitator to give it a bit more bite. And then together, I run them through the MV2 compressor. And the EQ is just taking, just clean, making sure that there's nothing below 60 on the bass track. Yeah, so that's the bass sound. So with the drums, so they're taking about 100 out of the drums, makes a bit of room for the bass there. Then we move on to the guitar tracks. There's three guitar tracks. There's this wah-wah guitar that runs pretty well all the way through it. There's two of them, so I've just panned those left and right. They go into a chord sort of pattern in the, I think it's the bridge type of section, but otherwise they're just doing that chunka-chunka all the way through. And my treatment of that's pretty basic. I take a little bit of the bottom end out, low cut, about 180. That's probably fairly high, but I like that on guitars. Sometimes if the part actually needs that body, I might leave a bit more of it in, but generally I'm making room for the bass. A little bit of compression and some tape saturation using the J37. Then the other guitar, it has three distinct parts. It's got a basic funk sort of chord pattern, and then it goes into a more distorted part. Then after that section, goes into a, because that's got a flange pedal or something, a flange effect of some sort on it. And then it goes back to the original funk sort of. So it's a three-part guitar track, and I treat that essentially the same way. Low cut filter, compression and saturation. I've got verb on all of these, which is running through this Hala Vintage Verb. It's about a second decay time and a eight and a bit millisecond pre-delay. I low cut from 400 down and high cut from 8,000 up. And that's the guitars. Then we move into the keys. There's essentially one core keyboard. There's a piano that plays just a single chord a couple of times through the song, and then there's four sets of string parts, synth strings. So the main keyboard part is this guy, and he's got a couple of different, he's got like a piano sound, but he's also got a Rhodes Fender sound. Now, whether there's two distinct instruments or he's flicked from one to the other, I don't know. It's quite a quick change. I wonder if it's different instruments and they've just dropped in different things. Quite a quick change. So they're the two main sounds, but they're all on one track. And I've treated all of the keys in a similar fashion to guitar. Take the bottom end out and just a touch of compression and tape saturation. The single piano part, obviously to emphasize the first chord as you go into the bridge, it's that's it. He just runs that out. He does that a couple of times during the song. Then we've got the strings, which are, there's four tracks. There's the bass one, and then there's two, a stereo set that I've done a full spread on, and then there's a high string as well. And together they sound. Very nice. Very 70s sounding, aren't they? But they're great. Now, so it's just the vocals left. So without listening to the vocals, this is what the band is up to at the moment. Those wah-wah guitars, they're percussion, aren't they? The vocals, there's four files, two are stereo, which I classify as the lead vocal tracks, and then there's two mono tracks, which I think I've treated as a harmony. The first of those sounds like these guys. Listen to the ground. What I'll do is take my processing off so you can hear how good the original recordings are. Listen to the ground, there is movement all around. I mean, that's great stuff. Listen to the ground, I haven't done a lot. Just a touch of EQ, a little bit of compression. See, I'm doing up to 3 dB, it's not a lot. When they recorded these, they'd have been compressing them. Just a touch of decapitator. And then I've got some delay and verb. And I treat the second lead the same way, because they tend to alternate, and it comes in as harmonies as well. So that's the second track, but it sort of takes over the lead. But then they come in together. I love all the little noises the guys are making. As you can see, I have edited a lot of the downtime in these files out, so you can hear headphone bleed through most of these tracks. But I've edited that out. But any of those little half notes almost, I've left those in. Clearly, if you listen to the original mix, you can hear them in there. Clearly, that's what they chose to do. And so I've left them that way too. All I've done is taken out the extraneous noise parts. The last vocal tracks are these two harmony ones. Sound. And the sweet city woman, she moved through the light. And I've just stereo panned those wide. So the vocals together, we'll go towards the end here. You can hear the call and response nature of their vocals. So. On the wind, making it mine. The bleed. We know. Great stuff. Love it. So then, just to finish off my mix, I run everything through mid-side processing. I do, on the sides, I take a lot of the bottom end out, sub-120 on this one, and I give a bit of a boost for the top end. And that centers the bass and gives a bit more width to the top end on the sides. And then I run through my mix bus processing. I won't go into that now. There's a few disabled in there, so it looks a bit messier than what it actually is. I hope you get something out of that. If you've got any comments or questions, just leave a comment. And otherwise, like, subscribe, all that stuff. And I hope to see you another time. Let's just take it out with the Bee Gees.